It's hard to imagine the beer industry in the United States today without the plethora of craft beer options available in more and more places. Never before have there been more tap rooms and bottle shops, but craft beer is also becoming a mainstay in sports stadiums and grocery stores. Craft beer sales have grown 50% in the last 5 years, but that growth has fueled a crazy amount of competition. Although this competition has been great for beer nerds like me, all the choices available out there have made it really difficult for brands to get noticed, and most importantly, chosen by thirsty beer lovers. Hey, this is Ryan with Beer by the Numbers, and branding has never been more important to a brewery than it is today. As a rather frequent beer consumer and beer nerd, I want to know what makes some branding choices more successful than others. And if there's a way to hack people's brains to get them to choose your beer more often. So get ready for a marketing and psychology lesson, and let's dive into the world of craft beer branding. So tap rooms get a lot of press in the beer world, and it's easy to see why. They are fun spaces full of interesting beer lovers, and they come with tons of great craft beers on tap. And while a tap room is a great way for a new brewery to get off the ground one pint at a time, if a brewery really wants to grow and be a sustainable business, they need to package and distribute their beer. More than 80% of the total US beer market volume is based in off-premise consumption, and as craft beer has grown, packaged and distributed beer has proven to be the most consistent source of growth for craft beer. Nowadays, 65% of craft beer sales are off-premise sales, as craft brewers are pursuing a more balanced growth strategy. This means that if a brewer wants to get at your sweet, sweet beer money, they need to pay attention to the marketing and branding factors surrounding off-site sales. On the flip side, the abundance of outlets and choices have made it difficult for any individual brand to get noticed in the off-site space. Crowded shelves at local bottle shops don't have unlimited space, and shop owners need to be very careful about their selection of brands to carry. There's a lot of money on the line. In 2016, brewers debuted more than 2,000 beer products, and more than 1,800 of those were craft beers. Again, in 2016 alone, 1,800 new craft beers hit the shelves in addition to the thousands that already crowd the space. It's pretty safe to say that a brewer needs every advantage they can get to get a thirsty drinker to choose their beer. According to Nielsen's Craft Beer Category Design Audit, 66% of American craft beer buyers say that a beer's package and label is very or extremely important for getting them to notice it. Additionally, 60% say that the package or label is very or extremely important in convincing them to give it a try and buy that beer. Overall, 71% of craft beer buyers say they like to try brands with bold and interesting packaging. While package and label design is relevant for all consumers, women are slightly more swayed by design than men, 75% versus 66% of men, when it comes to the craft beer category. So what makes a label irresistible to craft beer consumers? Again, if we turn back to the Nielsen data, we see that the three most important factors people look for on craft beer packaging are the design of the carrier or box, information about where the beer is produced, and the logo or brand name on the package. Let's take a look at each of these factors individually. Starting with the carrier or packaging design, we all know the look of the standard six-pack carrier. A branded cardboard sleeve with six bottles poking out the top, potentially showing a small label, and optimally designed for carrying in one hand. For most brands, using this standard design is common, but it works pretty well. But if you want to push the envelope a bit and stand out on the shelves, you can make your box portion sit higher or lower on the beers, or have windows that allow the beers to peek through, as this tends to catch consumers' eye as something different. However, doing something very different with six packs can be costly. Unique packaging options often cost twice as much or even more, and those costs have to spread over a paltry six beers. So oftentimes, craft brewers choose to mix things up with higher quantity boxes of brews. 12 and 24 packs are oftentimes where brewers try to make a unique design splash. Church Key sells their beer in a unique flat top can with a free opener right on the box for a unique experience. The Mexican beer Sol, while not a craft brand, pioneered boxes that open in a unique way, turning your box of bottles into a mini cooler perfect for sharing. And craft brewers have been experimenting with boxes that hold higher quantities of beer. 15 and 30 packs are quickly becoming consumer favorites as they see more value in buying bigger quantities of their favorite beers. These larger boxes are also good for stores as they don't have any unique shelf space requirements over 12 and 24 packs. So if you want your beer to get a little bit extra attention, consider a unique packaging design to stand out even before the thirsty drinker looks at any of your branding. Next, craft beer consumers really care about where a beer was produced. If your packaging does not mention where the beer was produced, craft beer consumers are much less likely to pick it up. Craft beer consumers love to know where their beer is coming from, partially because they favor locally made beers, and partially because they like to talk about their beers so damn much. Knowing where the beer comes from adds an extra connection between the consumer and the product. And with a product that is as carefully made as craft beer, that extra connection can really go a long way. So remember to at least put the state name where the beer was brewed, so that craft beer nerds like me have more bits of data to discuss with our nerdy friends. Finally, consumers love a good craft beer logo. Which of the following designs do you think stood out the most to consumers? I'll give you a couple seconds to think. If you guess Kona Brewing's Big Wave on the left, you're right. But why does this package stand out the most? Well, the first thing consumers tend to prefer is big, easy-to-read illustrations as logos. And that's much more over fancy lettering or small but sharp illustrations. So that tends to eliminate the two middle options as the most popular. Craft beer consumers also tend to be younger and more into exciting color schemes, meaning that consumers are likely to pick Big Wave versus the slightly toned down Fat Tire in this example. But that's not to say that these other sample brands aren't successful. In fact, they are very successful. But this is kind of like the branding Olympics, where only the best of the best can take home the gold. And in a world of thousands of craft beer choices, to truly stand out, you need to shoot for being the best of the best quality branding if you want to turn a nice profit. So if you're looking to sell some beer, have a unique package design, include information about where your beer was brewed, and have a bold and easy to read illustration plastered front and center. That way you are sure to capture the eye of consumers as they choose their next beer. What beer or brewery do you know that has really unique branding that stands out to you? Let me know down in the comments section below. And while you're down there, check out the link in the description and head over to the Beer by the Numbers Facebook group. We have a lot of great beer conversation over there, and I know you don't want to miss it. Once again, this has been Ryan with Beer by the Numbers, and I'll see you next week with more well-branded beer content.